Today I'm reviewing the Rapid Duty Classic, a car heavily based on the 70s and 80s Aston V8 Vantage, which was the fastest car in the world with a top speed of 170, unlike this car's top speed of 122. It also shares some similarities with the late 60s Mustang and the Jensen Interceptor Mark III. The car has a very unique and classy interior, and a decent amount of cosmetic upgrades, so you will stand out in a crowd. Note that if you want to buy this car, you should keep an extra 170 grand on the side to fully upgrade the performance before you even get to cosmetics, which can easily cost 200 to 300 grand. But the car itself costs 885 grand, which isn't the most expensive car in the game, it has a reasonable price. Either way, onto the lap time.
Fuck. Shit. Cock. Fuck's sake, no, shit.
Permission to say cock.
For God's sake. Fuck. That bad shit. No, God damn it. Fuck. Shit, shit. Is shit. God shit. Fuck. Just terrible shit.
Alright, this is a beautiful car, obviously. Absolutely gorgeous in every way. And it accelerates alright. And it spits out fire like a fucking dragon, look at that. Off the line, no wheel spin, perfect launch. At least I think it was. Look, already at 80, 90, 100. And now it's time to brake. Brakes aren't the best, and it understeers. That wing at the back, I don't think it does anything. Because wings are supposed to generate downforce, and that doesn't. It doesn't generate downforce, it does nothing. If anything, it makes lift. Look at that, just absolutely ludicrous. This is a ridiculous car. In the straights, it's great, really fast. I mean, obviously, it's based on the V8 Vantage, it's going to be fast. I mean, that was, at the time, the fastest car in the world. So you would think that this would be fast as well. And it is, but not in corners. It's not aerodynamic enough, I don't think. And the brakes aren't exactly superb either. I mean, I know I've got a broken brake button, and that's not even a joke, but still, the brakes aren't very good. Although, the time doesn't seem to be that bad. I mean, for a car that can't go around corners, it's going around corners fairly well. It might be the fact that I'm, you know, actually driving it like a human instead of an imbecile. But either way, it's not got the best time in the world, really good time still. And I don't exactly know what time that is. 19.84. That's okay. That's not very bad. And yeah, I'm happy with that.
Now for my conclusion. Should you spend your hard-earned money on this car? Well, it depends on your intentions. If you're looking for a track demon that gives an F1 car run for its money, then hell no. You shouldn't use it. You're better off with the Toyota Prius, because this thing oversteers around every corner. So, could you use it as a drift car? Perhaps. It's not bad when lowered. It drifts fine for me. No, I'm not really a drifter myself, but it drifted well enough that I could do these clips right here. Make fun of me in the comments all you like, I still don't know how to drift. So you could probably use it. I think it's more at home in car meets though, things like European and British car meets. Being a European and British car, it can fit in perfectly. Most people think it's a Mustang, so you can say, no, it's not a Mustang, it's a Aston Martin, and you can explain to them. But most people watching this are going to be the average player. Do I recommend it to you? No. If you want something for the sports classics, you want to use a Turismo Classic. It's cheaper, it's faster, it goes around corners without oversteering, and even if you want to use it to drift a little bit, you can drift in that car perfectly fine, if not better than you can in the Aston. But personally, I think I'm going to keep my old Aston Martin. I quite like it. It's grown on me. Maybe if you try it out, it might grow on you as well. See ya.